Life is a highway.
Life's a highway, baby. Welcome back to the big show. We're thrilled to have Angie filling in today.
And
I've received 7 emails.
Oh, excellent.
From viewers complimenting
haters?
Your outfit. No,
oh,
they
really?
Love your outfit
oh,
today.
They're not haters, they're congratulators?
They're congratulators.
Oh, okay, good.
They were all drag queens, but they love your outfit.
Drag queens love my outfit.
Drag queens love you. Uh-huh. It's just the way it goes.
I am flattered, though, because many of you know how to dress.
Hey, you know where I'm going to take you tonight?
Where?
Because I love you so much.
Okay, where?
We're going to go to a concert, not just any concert, one of the hottest shows playing in Colorado tonight. The fellas of Phish playing just up the road in Broomfield. Now, they created quite a stir when they played Red Rocks last, but now they're going to play 3 shows up at the First Bank Event Center in Broomfield. Mm-hmm. Tickets are just $60.
And it's Phish with a P.
It's Phish with a P. Going to be a great, great show. So go check them out. 3 nights there. Speaking of rock and roll, you know, we love those legendary rock concert posters.
We do.
And there is now an expo, an exhibit of great vintage rock art. Okay, now Chris Tomer loves the Grateful Dead, so he'd probably want this first poster. Psychedelic posters from the 60s are a big draw.
Tomer's a deadhead.
Right. He's not a deadhead. He just likes the Grateful Dead. How about Angie? You can grab your favorite concert poster at the expo.
Oh, I love me some Barry.
You love you some Barry. Goes down at the Aloft Hotel in Broomfield all day today.
Okay.
The Aloft Hotel in Broomfield. Thousands of concert posters spanning the ages.
Uh-huh.
And you know they got my favorite, too.
Of course.
Right there.
Hello, Liza.
Hello, Liza. Isn't that cool?
Uh-huh.
So head to rockartexpo.com. Tickets are only $5. It's going to be a great way to pick up some cool stuff.
Yeah, I like
now,
that
we asked our Facebook fans, hey, what's the best concert of all time? Since we're talking about concerts, Chris Bort says it's a toss-up between Kiss and Kid Rock. Tanya Prince said Prince's Musicology Tour was the best. And then, of course, Greg Marquez, well, he picked our number one concert of all time. How about it? Far and away, U2 at Red Rocks, the number one best concert
Love
of
it.
All time, sir.
All time.
There's never been a better show than that show. Except for Liza Minnelli at the Hollywood Bowl.
Oh, that's lovely.
Let's head out now to the heart of Hollywood, TMZ.com. We'll ask Dax. He's an honest man. Dax, what is the best rock concert of all time? The best show you've ever seen?
Oh, well, I don't know if I've been to any big, huge rock concerts. But can I just tell you my favorite concert?
Sure.
I really enjoyed Dave Matthews Band out there. I watched it in Denver.
I'll bet you did. They're at Red Rocks?
They weren't Red Rocks. They were at the old stadium.
Oh, cool. He likes Dave Matthews Band.
Yes, he does.
He's a rocker. Let's talk about Oprah. She's on this afternoon, and she's lost Oksana, but she's got Jackson family?
She does. Oprah stopped by the Jackson compound over in Encino, the one where Catherine lives with the kids. She stopped in, did an entire interview. Looks like it's going to be centered around Michael Jackson, obviously, and then the kids and what's going on in their life, Catherine's new book. This should be a very, very huge show for Oprah because everyone wants to know anything about Jackson, and considering they're inside the house, it's going to have huge, huge ratings.
We love Oprah. All right. Dax, we're out of time today, but we'll check in with you again tomorrow. TMZ.com, my favorite website. Dax, a man who likes Dave Matthews Band, mm-hmm. right there in Hollywood. We'll talk to you tomorrow on the show.
Later, Chris.
Take it easy. We love viral video on this program. Angie, have you seen the new one out of China?
I have, Chris, and it's delightful.
It's China's Got Talent. They crowned the winner, and he is a truly amazing guy.
He is.
All right, he's an armless pianist who tickles the ivories with his toes. He won the first season. Say hello to Lu Wei. He's 23, and he sang James Blunt's You're Beautiful in the finals in Shanghai just last night. Were you there?
No, but I've seen him perform. He's pretty amazing. Not in person.
He lost his arms in a crash. He really is an inspiring story. He actually beat out a 7-year-old comedian and a 23-year-old aspiring rocker. He only learned the piano 3 years ago.
Unbelievable.
Isn't that cool?
It's just cool to see what you can, you know, do if you set your mind to it.
The human spirit, I swear, is the most inspiring thing. So congrats to him.
Congrats to him.
I love many things about Angie Austin, but most of all, your eyelashes are okay. Yeah. But I love your manly Paul Bunyan man hands.
My man hands.
Look at these man hands.
Man hands.
You're like Hungry Jack dinners. You're not the only one. Tina Fey. The cover of her new book has just come out. They leaked it accidentally.
I thought she was daintier than that. That's a
man. Isn't that hilarious?
That's a man arm.
Her new book is called Bossy Pants. Publishers spent $6 million to secure the rights to the book. And yes, Tina Fey with her man hands.
It's so weird because we always call you that behind your back.
Man hands?
On the show. No, Bossy Pants.
Oh, Bossy Pants.
Yeah, not man hands. No, you have dainty little fingers.
I have lady fingers. That book, by the way, will hit shelves next April. How about Justin Bieber? Who here on the program likes Justin Bieber? Cold
silence.
As ice in here.
Silence. There's two grown men in here like, oh, I love the Bieber. I love the Beeb.
Fellas, you're going to love me more now because he has his own line of fingernail polish.
Oh, excellent.
Yes, the teen heartthrob has signed a deal to have fingernail polish in all the Walmarts in America. Everyone will be named after a different one of his songs. It's called the One Less Lonely Girl Collection. Among those colors, prize possession purple, OMB bright red, and step to the beat glitter. It's going to be great, huh?
Well, Steve there in the studio says he's never had a mani-pedi, so he doesn't know who Bieber is.
The grown men in our studio audience are thrilled at this. They cannot wait to get their hands on the OMB glitter. Oh, look at them. They are excited.
Love
fellas,
me a good mani-pedi.
Not till Christmas. Doesn't come out till Christmas. Hey, we have a great segment on this show. It is called Ear Candy. Okay, and here's the deal. We want you to have the hottest, freshest music for your iPod, so when you go to work out, you got the perfect brand new tunes. That sound cool?
Yes.
You like that?
Yes.
There's the perfect guy, only one guy to give it to you. It's Mr. Joe Young with this week's Ear Candy.
Hey guys, Joe here with another week of Ear Candy. I have 5 songs you gotta have for your iPod. We're gonna go ahead and get you started at number 5. It's Jason Derulo with In My Head, the Wide Boys mix. At number 4, Charisse with Pyramid, the Dave Audet mix. At number 3, Alexandra Burke, Bad Boys, the Moto Blanco mix. At number 2, Carmen Reese with Raindrop, the Dave Audet mix. And your number 1 download, check out the Sweet Sounds of the Saturdays. That right there was The Saturdays with Hire. You can find all my Ear Candy online at kwgn.com/everyday. Enjoy your workout, and I'll see you next week.
Good
Love
stuff.
Love Joe and all the ladies who are interested in Joe.
It's not eye candy, it's ear candy, okay?
Yes, yes.
He has a job to do, ladies, so lay off Joe Young.
And there is something standing between me and Joe, and his name is Mark, it's my husband.
Yeah, you are married.
Other than that,
we would be... Hey, coming up next, we're thrilled.